Greetings. I recently had a lengthy message exchange on YouTube with a Mohammedan, and my friend provided a transparent insight into the mind of a Mohammedan. He wrote, "And do you think that the Creator, who created every cell and every molecule, earth and skies, should love men before they loved Him? Do you think God is a game?" And then he tries to quote Christians. "No, God loved us before, so we should love Him more. Is this how you think about your Creator?" Let's take a closer look at this thinking that is formed in the mind of Mohammedans. I'm going to skip the adjectives for a moment, the ones in between, who created every cell and every molecule, earth and sky. Do you think that the Creator should love men before they loved Him? It is a very revealing question, and it comes from a very clear mindset of Islam. In the mind of Islam, the Allah of Islam does not love anyone until the sinner, the person, the human, the sycophant, first loves Allah. Notice the second portion of the original post. "No, God loved us before, so we should love Him more. Is this how you think about your Creator?" He asks, "Is this how you think about your Creator?" I think he was being sincere, trying to phrase how he imagines Christians think about God. And you know what? He is absolutely correct. Christians do follow the God of Abraham, who first loves mankind before any man can possibly love God. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Romans 5:8, "But God demonstrates His own love toward us, in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." Notice, while we were sinners, we did not love God yet. 1 John 3:16, "By this we know love, because He laid down His life for us." Not we laid our life down for Him. 1 John 4:19, "We love Him because He first loved us." It cannot be stated any more clearly than that. We love Him because He first loved us. So the Mohammedan was right in how he described the Christian mindset. The revealing thing is that he thinks there is something wrong with the way we believe. But this is an absolutely crystal clear difference between the God of the Bible and Torah and the Allah of Muhammad. Allah only loves those who love Him first. And I think I had a good answer to give my friend, and I think you should read it and understand it as well. Actually, I think it is absolutely impossible for you or any man to love God first. We are not even able to sense or understand God. So if we cannot love our fellow man who we can see and can talk with, how can we love God who we cannot see and cannot comprehend? Beyond that, God existed before you, right? Or do you think you existed before God? So if God existed before you, do you think in the eons that He has existed, He has never had any compassion or charity or love for a being before that being loved Him? The argument for your religion makes no sense, my friend. He replied with a hypothetical scenario. But if you have two workers exactly the same in everything, but one is always with you, smiling at you, didn't talk behind you, you'll obviously reward the hard-working one, right? Also, if you want, you can fire them both just like that, since you owned everything. God is always with us, my friend. The imaginary scenario may make sense between you and two friends, but not between God and two people. Can anyone shout and God not be there to hear it? No. He wrote, "But God said he is merciful, loves the one who loves him truly." Notice these are his words. He states, "Allah loves the ones who love him truly." To be clear, Muhammad said that Allah said. This is called hearsay. Allah loves those who truly love him. The real problem with this view, my friend, is that it ascribes to your Allah human behavior. We only love those who love us. We love those who give us gifts. We love those who are kind to us. We love those who do favors for us. We love those who show us love first. If men can only reflect love, and Allah can only love those who love him first, there can never be love between Allah and those who claim to submit to him. So Almighty God, who is not a man and is not limited by human emotions, can and does show his love for mankind before we love him. But he does not only love those who love him. God loves all men, and his love is what draws men unto him. If we only respond to God out of fear, we are no better than dogs who get swatted with a newspaper and perform tricks to avoid punishment. So your God loves sinners, Hindus, Muslims, the ones who worship him, the ones who disrespect him. Reconsider your reply. God does love all men, even those who disrespect him and revile him. This is what makes God great, my friend, greater than any pagan idol men are told to bow down to. So it means that I'm going to heaven. The killers, rapers, thieves, all people will go to heaven. Wow, your God is really generous. Why then gave you teachings or Ten Commandments if everyone is loved and will never be tortured? God loving you does not mean you go to heaven. It means that God has provided a means of salvation for you, which you then either accept or reject. But the choice is yours, brother. No, God loving you is like God paying for a ticket for you at the train station. You must still go to the train station, accept the ticket you have been told about, and get on the train. Only those who accept the Son of God, my friend, and confess that Jesus is Yahweh, will have found the ticket office and boarded the train. All the other tickets will go unused and the seats on the train will be unoccupied. If your pride says, "No, I will pay my own way," then you reject the free gift and you will quickly find out you cannot afford to pay the ticket. This is actually why God offered and paid your ticket for you. He knew the cost of the ticket, and he knew you could not pay it in full. The gift of the free ticket is offered to all men, my friend, because God's love does extend to all men who will accept his gift. Now, to be clear, I got the meat of my answer from Jesus himself in the Word of God, because Jesus had something very direct to say about the behavior of Allah. "For if you love them which love you, what thanks have you? For sinners also love those that love them." Think about that if you call yourself Muslim. Jesus said that Allah's love is no better than a sinner's love. Allah only loves those who love him first. While my friend has not yet made a change of heart, the seed I planted was good seed, and I hope you may derive benefit from our messages. Be very aware of the true face of the Allah of Islam. This spirit is not the loving God who loves all men first. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.